Good morning, everyone. In the last class, we are trying to discuss with our tree set example here. So what is the advantage we are going to get from the tree set? So like whenever we are trying to add an element inside this particular tree set, so by default, we are getting an ascending order here. Getting the point? This is the one advantage we are going to get from the tree set, as well as we identify the linked hash set. So linked hash set is also one of the implementation class. But here, what is the advantage we are going to get? How we are going to insert the element? The same way we are going to get an element while retrieving an object from the particular linked hash set class. And previously we discussed with our hash set, we cannot understand the how we are going to insert it, because internally it's going to work on the so hashing mechanism. By default, based on the hash code of the key, the objects are going to store into the different node here, right? So these are about the implementation classes of the particular set, and inside internally the implemented sorted set and navigable set. So I'm requesting here, try to find out the each and every method, how it is implemented inside this particular implementation classes. So what is the implementation class for the sorted set and navigable set? Tree set. Inside this particular tree set, we need to focus on to the remaining methods here, like peak method, element method, some of the method we are having. So inside this particular navigable set, okay, so we identified how we need to check with the implementation classes, like how the each method is implemented. We identified here, right? Now same way, we need to focus on to the remaining method which are available inside this particular tree set class. Okay, so back to here, so we need to go for the queue here. So queue is a interface, and the implementation class for this particular queue, it is a priority queue. So we already discussed here, like first in last out can go for the this particular queue here. We'll understand here, so we are having one implementation class, so that is called priority queue. The priority queue, so priority queue is our implementation class. So priority test, I'm trying to take the class. So inside this particular priority test class, now what I'm doing here, I'm trying to work on the priority queue. Priority queue. So priority queue is also a generic type. So instead of string, now you can take any other data types also as well. And if you want to work with any custom data type also, so we can work like this, right? Now observe priority queue. So PQ is equals to new. So priority queue, how many constructed we are having? The first one default constructor, second one int capacity constructor, carrying the pun. So third one, now you can see comparator is expecting here, and fourth constructor, now you can see which is expecting collection, carrying the pun, and collection is expecting. So priority queue is expecting, and sorted set. So these are the constructors we are having here. These are the constructors we are having inside this particular priority queue. So observe carefully here. So capacity comparator and capacity comparator, sorted set, priority queue, initial capacity comparators, collection, and default queue. So these many constructors. Getting the point. So each and every constructor we will have the different purpose here. Now you can see abstract queue. Abstract queue we already discussed in our earlier example, and the abstract queue is implemented queue interface. Now you can see what is the default capacity we are having, 11. So default capacity we are having 11. Now understand here, so the objects, the queue objects are going to store in the object array, same way in our array list class. same way in our realistic class. So comparator. So we will see the comparator mod count. For each and every operation, we are going to understand the mod count, right? So default capacity and null. And this is the initial capacity. So these are the constructors. Cutting the point. These are the constructors we identified. So after identifying the constructors here, now observe. So these are the private methods. So ensure non-empty and enter from the priority queue. Right. So enter from the collection. Cutting the point. Now we need to focus on to the Boolean method. So add method, internally it is calling offer method. The offer method now you can see. So it is growing. So priority queue also internally is working based on the arrays concepts here. The objects are going to store in our array. Cutting the point. So mod count to queue. So queue we already discussed here. It is an object array. Whatever the element we are going to call, like we are going to store. So those objects will store into the this particular object array. Now you can see peak method, index of method, remove method, cutting the point. So these are the method. Now we can understand here how these particular objects are implemented here. Okay, so back to here in the priority queue. Now what I want to do? PQ dot add. So this is our string here. Cutting the point. So this is the add method we are going to call to insert an element into this particular elements here. Observe here. Now what I want to do, I want to print this particular PQ. I want to print this particular PQ here. So let's see if I'm going to run this particular example. So what is the output we are getting here? Right. So AABB, CCDD, QQ, and Z. So these are the output here. This is a way we can create the priority queue object, cutting the point. So we can add an element here. And inside this particular queue interface, so what are the method we are having? So add method we already identified internally, it is calling offer method. So remove method. So remove method will remove the object. And pull method. Cutting the point. So pull method. So what it will do, this particular pull method here, it will try to retrieve and remove the element here. And element peak. So let's see. So how this particular pull method is implemented. Observe the pull method. So this is the ES we are going to get. Cutting the point. So this is our ES we are going to get here. And we are checking the condition here. We are checking the condition. So like what we are doing here, Q is equals to ES. And the zero element we are trying to making as a not null. And so those we are trying to store into this particular result. If the condition will satisfy, now what we are doing here? We are trying to find out the particular size minus minus. So we are trying to decrease in the size minus minus, and we are trying to find out the last index element. And now what we are doing is, so we are checking here if this particular n is greater than 0, we are trying to find the comparator here. So this particular comparator is equals to this particular comparator. So we are going to work on the countdown comparable. So otherwise we'll work for the comparator here. So this is the way we'll remove the particular element and we'll return the result here. Okay, we'll observe what are the methods. So add method we identified internally, it is calling offer method. Now, so remove method. Remove method. So this is the specific method which we implemented in our particular priority queue. So let's see how this particular implementation section is, how this particular implementation section is working here. So add method, the remove method I'm trying to call here, observe here. So remove method internally it is calling pull method. So just now we identify the particular pull method. Getting the point. Now observe the condition is satisfying. Yes, mod count plus plus into n we are declaring, and what is the x we are getting here? Something called zz, the last element. The last element. When we are trying to call this particular remove method or pull method, now what happened internally? We are trying to load last element from the particular queue. So now you can see this is the queue we are having. So it will storing object up to the 5 because the priority queue we are having, so 11 elements. The default capacity we are having 11, right? Now, so what is the n we are having as of now? 5. Now what I'm doing here, I'm trying to make null. I'm trying to making null here. So why I'm making null here? Why I'm making the null? Because we are calling remove method. We are trying to remove the object. So when we are calling the remove without the parameter, it will try to remove from the last element. So this is we need to understand here. Now observe in the ES location, the fifth index. In the ES location, fifth index we are having ZZ. Now let's see after completion of the 578. Now if I'm going to move to the fifth, now you can see null. Now what you are understanding here? We are trying to like we remove the element from the priority queue. So now n greater than 0. So we are checking we are trying to work for the comparator or not. So we are not working for the comparator. Now shift down the comparable. Now what it will do here internally, so it's going to change the indexes locations here, going to change the index location here. But so what we need to focus carefully here, so what we need to focus carefully here, we need to focus carefully how the objects are removing it, and so how many hop we are having? So 2. Child 3 we are making. Where is the what is the key we are having here? ZZ. And in the third location, observe this particular objects are changed here. This particular objects are changed here. So finally, if you see, if you observe here, based on the default sorting nature here, we are finding here, and the result. So result we are getting double A here. The result we are getting double A here. But if you observe carefully, what object is removed here? Getting the point. So we need to focus carefully. Basically, inside this particular ES, so these are the objects are reordered here, but our object will remove here the particular double A. The first object is removed here. So x not equals to null, we are trying to return the x here. Right? So this is all about the remove method. Internally, we identified the pull method also. So we need to check for the element method. So whenever we are trying to work for the element, internally, so we need to focus onto the which method we need to focus. So the peak method we need to focus here. Now observe. Now observe here the element method I'm trying to call. Internally, peak method we are calling. So we need to focus onto the peak method. So what we are doing here, in the zero index location, what is the element we are having? We are trying to return here. So this is the way the peak method is going to work. And here, so they are checking the condition. If the x is not equal to null, we are returning x. So otherwise, we'll throw an element here. So this is all about the element and internally, so the peak method. So this is all about the priority queue, all method we discuss here. The priority queue, all method we discuss here. Getting the point. So here, we need to focus on to the, basically, so it's going to, this particular queue is going to, so like reorder the, based on the, our priority here. So priority is nothing but, based on the, this particular, so hash code internally they are going to generate the hash code. So based on that, the objects are going to, so like reorder the, carrying the point. So objects are going to reorder based on our priority here. The priority we are going to get from the our hash code. So this is all about the priority queue. So which is implemented from the queue interface, right? So finally, we need to focus on to the last implementation class. So that is called ArrayDQ. Getting the point. So ArrayDQ is implementing from the which interface? So DQ interface. So ArrayDQ is our implementation class. We'll observe how this particular ArrayDQ will work here. So ArrayDQ, and we want to work on the string here. AD is equals to new ArrayDQ. Observe. So ArrayDQ we are having default constructor. So second constructor which is expecting collection, and third constructor we are having number of elements here. So these are all about the constructors which are we are having inside this particular ArrayDQ. So let me open this particular ArrayDQ here. ArrayDQ is extending abstract collection and is implementing, so DQ interface is implementing from the DQ interface. So ArrayDQ also internally is using object array to store the element here, right? But here we need to focus here head object, so tail object here, and so max array size internally we are calling the grow method. So new capacity, getting the point, new capacity. So and now you can observe ArrayDQ, whenever we are calling the default capacity, so how many elements we are storing here? 16 plus 1 here, around we are trying to store the 17 elements here. And this is the another capacity, how many number of elements we want to store. So here we can specify the, so explicit capacity we are going to specify. And this is the DQ, ArrayDQ, which is expecting collection, right? So these are the constructors here. Okay, now we identify whenever we are calling the default constructor, we'll get an 17 objects here. We'll get an 17 objects here. So I want to add this particular method. How this particular add method is working? Getting the point. We need to focus how this particular add method will work internally. Now move on to the add method. Now we can see internally which method we are calling, add last method. Okay, now I'm trying to call the add last method. So you can see add last method is checking the null and is going to throw a null pointer exception. So now you can see elements. So how many elements we are having? So focus here, so we are having 0 to 16. So 0 to 16, it will become 17 elements. By default, we can store 17 elements here. Okay, now, so yes, tail is a how much? 0. Now we can see this is the object we are storing. So in which index location it's storing? It's storing in the 0 index location. Now we can see, so AR, the AR we added here, right? And so if it is, if this particular condition, if it will satisfy, internally they are going to call grow. So they are going to call grow. So it will grow one element here. So we need to store the one more element here. Getting the point? So this is all for the add last method. And the add last method is calling from the which method? Add method. Hit and true. Right? So this is we identified the add method. Internally it's calling add last method. Okay. So we need to check for the add first. So what it will do? So we call the internally tail reference, right? When we are calling this particular add first, what method is like, what is the reference it's going to call? Now you can see ad dot add first method. Here I want to add first element. Observe, so the difference we need to understand here only. So it's going to check for the, so ES array brace, and inside this particular array brace, so we are going to pass head here. Now observe, so it is not null, and we are loading this particular element. So as of now, we inserted 1, and now we can see here what we are doing here. Now we can observe head we are passing here. So head also we are having 0. Cutting the point, and also we are having 0. Internally we are having, so one more method. So what exactly which is doing here? So ES dot length we are having 0. So ES dot length we are having 1. Right, now observe this particular ES dot length we are having 17. So the capacity we are having 17 here, right? And head we are having 0. Now what we are doing internally, this particular DEC, so what exactly it is doing here? So they are trying to find out the modules -1, and they are trying to store into this particular I, and it will return the particular I value here. So it will try to return the particular I value. Okay, now observe the module, sorry, the DEC method is working like this internally. So if I'm going to find out the value, what is the value we are getting? We are getting 16. Now what we are doing here? So the head will become 16, and in the 16 index location, this particular object is going to store. Now we can see. So in the 16 index location, the first is stored. So because of this particular method, the value we return as a 16, and it's stored here. So head we are having 16, the tail we are having 1. So both are not equals to, So the grow method will not call. Getting the point? Now, If I'm going to print this particular AD values here, now what I'm printing internally? So restart here. Now observe. So first and AR we are getting. How we are getting this particular first and AR here? Let's see. We'll try to debug one more time here. First method. Now internally, how many elements we are having? So only one element here. So 16 also null. in the ES location we written as a first year. Carrying the pen. So the 16 element is stored into the 16 index location. Now finally we coming out of the this particular object here. But now, so what we need to focus here, whenever I'm trying to call this particular AD, we need to understand the ArrayDQ. Inside this particular ArrayDQ, we are having, so toString method is not implemented. So from this particular abstract collection, the toString we are going to work here. What happened here? Why this particular toString is not coming? So this is the object we are getting here. Okay, the toString is not providing the information basically. So I'm trying to find out the toString information. So it is not loading. Okay, so anyway, so we identify add first method, it will try to loading the newly added object first time here, and the add last method we identified offer first. So what exactly this particular offer first is doing here? So if I'm going to call ad dot offer first here, and so inside this particular string also I'm adding offer first. Let's see how this particular offer first is going to work. And as of now, now you can observe in our ArrayDQ the elements we are getting as a first and AR and offer first. If I'm going to move, now you can observe offer first internally it is calling add first method. Internally it is calling add first method. So just now we identified add first here. If I'm trying to print, observe offer first is coming as a first element and first and AR. Getting the point. So offer first as well as add first both are performing same here. Both are performing same here. But what is the difference we are going to have here? So the difference here, if the element was added into the queue, so else it will return false. Right. And what about this particular add method? Add first method, so it will throw an exception. If the object is like if we don't have a space, like if the capacity is filled here, we are going to get an exception. But the same thing we are not going to get from the offer first. So this is only the difference here. And remove methods. So remove method we already identified here. So just for understanding, we'll go for the remove first. Remove first. And here the remove first method will remove the first element of the ArrayDQ here. And now you can see remove first method internally, which is expecting pull first here. And if the E we are going to get null, so we'll get an exception. Okay, we'll see how this particular pull first is, it will try to working here. Now what is the head we are having? 15. Head we are having 15 here. Cutting the pen. Now, so what is the element we are having? So these are the elements here. And now what we are doing here? Basically, based on this particular ES and H here, we are trying to find out the element here. So what is the element we are trying to find out here? Offer first. So this is the first method. Sorry, the first element we are finding here. So based on this particular method, we are going to find out the first element here. Now if you can see, so object array and int I. Object array and int I. The h we are going to get as a 15. So based on this particular 15, we will return the particular element here. And the element we are going to get as a offer first. Right. If the e equals to not null. And what we are doing here? So here, now we can see we are making the null. The h we are having 15. The 15 index location, what is the object we are having? So the object will become null. The object will become null. Right, offer first it is removed here. The particular offer first is removed. And whatever the element we are returning, so the element we are trying to returning from the pool first method. Now you can observe only we are having two. The offer first is removed here. So this is the way the remove first method will internally checking pool first method. Right? Now you need to focus on to the each and every method. So how it is functioning internally. Right? So this is all about the DQ array. So any questions, the priority queue as well as DQ array. Priority queue as well as DQ array we discuss here. Okay, now, so we need to focus on to the iterator classes. So basically, we are having two iterator classes here. So those are the interfaces here. The first iterator, this is the iterator. Iterator is an interface here. So which is having hasNext and next method. hasNext and next method. So same way, we are having one more list iterator. We are having list iterator. So basically, this particular list iterator is going to perform the bidirectional operation. So it's going to find out the next element. But the iterator, we can work on the only next element. So in the iterator, we can work on the only next element. So whether this particular method we are going to check, whether we are having any next element or not, we are going to check. If it is having, we can find out the next year. But now you can see in the list iterator, so has next, next, and has previous and previous. Getting the point. So here we are having bidirectional operation. It's going to work on the previous element. So as well as it's going to work for the next element here. And basically these two iterators, what is exactly the purpose it's going to provide? To work on the one by one element here. Getting the point. To work on the one by one element here, we can go for the this particular iterator. So along with the like getting the one by one element, so we are going to have an option to remove the element also. Getting the point. So we'll have a remove method. We can remove the particular element from the given collection here. Because this particular iterator and list iterator, so in our all the interfaces, all the interfaces having the iterator method here. Okay, so we'll observe how this particular iterator and list iterators are going to work. So to understand here, now what I'm doing here, I'm moving into ArrayList example here. I'm moving into this particular ArrayList example. So we need to focus how this particular ArrayList example is going to work. Getting the point. Now observe. So this is about the al.iterator. Now focus here, iterator is an interface. Getting the point. The interface reference object we are getting here. So using this particular iterator dot has next here. Getting the point. So we need to focus on to the has next here. And now here I want to print the value. I want to print the value. So using iterator dot next method. iterator dot next method. So if you observe carefully here, this particular iterator, so how it is working. Let me so change the debug perspective. Now observe iterator we are getting. So has next we are having next element. So next element. So next element. So every time we are getting an element here. So this is the way we can work on the iterator here. So this is the way we can work on the iterator. Now observe the operation is completed. And along with this particular iteration, now focus iterator dot remove method. Iterator dot remove method. So we can trying to remove the all the elements from the all the elements from the particular array list class. Observe here. So objects are printing and objects are removing. Now observe. So still how many elements we are having? So we are having more 3 elements here. Now you can see 2 elements. So now you can see all the elements are removing here. All the elements are removing here. Only null we are having. So in the zero index location we are having null. Remaining objects are removed here. Remaining objects are removed here. Right. All the objects are removed. Now you can see empty. The array list object is empty. Cutting the point. So this is the way we can work on the this particular iterator. And the same way, what is the one more advantage we are going to get here? AL dot list iterator. So this is our list iterator. Now here we are having option to work on the so as next and as previous. List iterator dot so because already we identified as next and as previous. So like as next we identified we'll go for the as previous. We need to copy and here list iterator dot previous element. List iterator dot previous element. Same way. Now what we can do, we can go for the one more while loop here. As next here and next element. As next and next element. So this is all about the list iterator here. This is all about the list iterator. Now focus here. Now we are inside this particular iteration. So once this particular iteration is completed, so we enter into the list iterator object. Cutting the pen. So this is the list iterator. Now you can see we are trying to work on the list iterator. We are trying to work on the list iterator and it is having one advantage. So we can work for the bi-directional operation. Now you can see, so which is having previous elements. The previous elements also we are trying to print. Getting the point. So this is the difference between iterator and list iterator. So the same object, so we repeated multiple times with help of this particular iterator as well as list iterator. Right. And so this is the method I suggested we'll discuss in our last examples here. Now you can see, so this is the iterator we are having and in the list interface we are having list iterator. Cutting the point. So this is the list iterator. So this is we discuss here. Now what we can do, so we need to focus on to the map related example here. Getting the point? So map related example we need to focus. So as of now, all the implementation classes we discuss here. Getting the point? All the implementation classes we discuss here. What are the implementation classes we are having? First one, array list, linked list, hash set, linked hash set, and tree set, priority queue, and RAD queue. So these are the implementation classes for our interfaces called list interface, set interface, sorted set, navigable set, and queue. And finally, we are having so DQ. These many interfaces we identified. So now we are moving into the so another concept here, because the collection framework having so like what we can call it as a two parts here. So inside this particular two part, we discuss the first part. So that is called collection related. And the second one, we are going to discuss map here. So map also interface we are having, and it's going to look like this. K comma V. Basically, map will store key value pairs. Map will store key value pair. Getting the point. So in the map related, how many interfaces we are having? So first we'll go for the map interface here. So let me open map here. So this is also implemented inside the package called java.util package. Now we can observe it is our interface. So which is expecting map k comma v. K comma key is nothing but, so k is, it's going to work as a key, and v is going to work for the value. Getting the point? And the previous collection part, we used to work with the element here. But in the map section, we are going to work for the some different here. Okay. And size method. So by seeing the name of the method, we can easily understand here. We can easily understand here. Now we can see size method we already identified is the method. Cutting the point. So is empty method we already so discussed in the previous sections here, contains key. So the difference here, previously we identified the content, but here we are working with the contains key here. Here we are working with the contains key. So the given key is available or not, we can identify. And the same way we can understand the contains value method. Contains value method. Right. Now we can see the contains value method, we can understand. And whenever we are providing the key, we are going to get an object here. So object key we are passing, we are trying to load value here. And put method. So this is a put method is important. How we identified the add method, same way this particular put method is going to work. And here now if you observe, what we are passing here, key comma value, and what is returning, value it is returning, the put method, right? And remove method. So the remove method we already identified in the previous example. So based on the key, the value is going to remove here, and whatever the value we are trying to return it. So whatever the value we are trying to remove it, the value will return here. The value will return. Cutting the point. So put all. Now you can see extending this particular put all, we can work on the map related examples here. We can specify the one more map, and we can store into this particular map here. So clear method, we can remove the all the elements here, key set here. So this is important. If we want to load only keys here, we can go for the method called key set here. So this is the purpose of this particular key set here, right? Values. If you want to load only values here, now we can go for this particular values here. only values we can load. And here now we can see, so we can store, like we can load key comma value as a pair, cutting the comma, key comma value as a pair, we can go for the entry set here, entry set, and internally we are having entry. So this is the one more interface, so which is implemented internally in the map section, in the map section, map dot entry. So map dot entry, cutting the pen. So this is the one more interface. Now you can observe, basically to understand the map dot entry, whenever we are calling this particular entry method, we are going to get an map dot entry reference. Other than this, we are not going to get. Now you can see internally, so get key we are having, get value we are having, and what is another method we are having is set value. Right. So most of the time, I think these are the three boolean equals method. So we know hash code method also we know, right? So this is coming from the 8 method. So comparator, and this is also coming from the Java 8. So right, only get key, get value, set value. These are the three methods available inside the interface called map dot entry. Getting the point. Now equals method. So hash code method. Right. So these are the default method. So what are the main method we can focus here? So these are the main methods here. So by seeing the name of the method, we can easily understand here how the each method is implemented. Cutting the point. So I don't want to provide one more time the explanation of each method here, because we already discussed this, the each and every method in a previous example. Okay. So this is a map interface. So it's going to store key comma value. Internally, one more interface we are having, the interface called entry interface. So which is having some of the methods. What are the methods it's having? The first method called get key, get value, set value, right? And another interface we need to focus here, navigable map. So how we identify the navigable map? Same way we can go for the, okay, first we'll go for the sorted map. So sort navigable map is extending from the sorted map. Now you can see this is the sorted map. So sorted map is extending from the map. Kind of point. Sorted map is extending from the map here, and internally now you can see comparator. So basically, why the sorted map having the comparator? So to store an element in a sorting order, whether it is ascending or descending, we can go for the this particular comparator. After completion of this particular map related example, so we'll focus on to the comparator here. So how this particular examples are going to work. Okay, now understand here the particular comparator is having submap. So how we identify the subset here, same way we are having inside this particular navigable map, sorry, sorted map. Sorted map also will expect here k comma value, and is extending from the map. Right. And inside this, we are having one method called submap. So what it will do? So it's going to return the, based on this particular key value, so it's going to return the map here. So same way head map. So head map here, what is we are providing only key. So based on this particular key, it will return the head map here. And finally, so what we need to focus here? So tail map. Cutting the point. So tail map. From the key, so how many elements we are going to have? So those who based on the from the key, how many elements we are going to have, it will construct the new sorted map object and it will return. And now you can see first key method and last key method. To find out the first key and the last key, we can go for this particular two methods and key set. So this particular key set we already discussed is coming from the map here. So collection values and entry set. These are also coming from the map here. Cutting the point. Now you can see, so key set, values, and entry set. So these three are also available inside this particular. So which interface it is? Something called navigable sorted set, not the navigable map, sorted map here, sorry. So not the sorted set here, it is a sorted map here. So this is all about the sorted map. And finally, we are going to discuss the navigable map. Navigable map is extending from the sorted map. So once it is extending, we already identified all the elements we can access. All the particular method, whatever the method we are having inside this particular sorted map. So everything we can access into the this particular navigable map. And the lower entry. Basically, this section of code we can see when we are trying to discuss the tree map, because the tree map is providing all the information. Okay, so I'm not copying, because the navigable map will having a lot of methods here. We'll try to focus on today one by one. Okay, these are the interfaces we are having inside this particular map related interfaces. So this is the second part we are discussing here. And inside the second part, I want to take as the first implementation class called HashMap. So this particular HashMap test here is the implementation of HashMap test is our implementation of which interface? Map interface. Now you can observe HashMap. So what is the key? I want to give as a key string, and key also I want to give. So key also I want to give the same key, the string only. So otherwise we can go for the double here. And hash map here is equals to new hash map. And focus here, default constructor, capacity constructor. So it is expecting map related one collection of objects here, right? And initial capacity and load factor. Cutting the pan. And so if you observe, hash set also internally is going to work on the hash map here. Hash set also is going to work on the internally hash map. Now we'll see hash map how it is implemented. So it is extending from abstract map. Cutting the pan. So how we identify the abstract collection? Same way in the map side also we are going to have abstract classes here. The first one called abstract map and is implementing map related interface here. Now you can observe here this particular hash map. So what is the default capacity here we are having? So we are going to get to 16 here, and minimum capacity and default load factor. Threshold here. So this is the threshold here. We need to see how these particular thresholds are implemented. And if you observe internally, HashMap is working internally node concept here. HashMap internally it is working node concept. So we'll see how these particular nodes are implemented. But now, so focus on to the hash method comparable class. First we need to check for the constructor. So this is the constructor. HashMap we are having initial capacity load factor, right? And this is the initial capacity what we are expecting here. And this is the default constructor. So load factor, how we are working here load factor here. So this is the default load factor, that is we are going to have so 0.75, and the default capacity we are having 16. Getting the point. So these are the constructors we are having, right? So after adding this particular constructors here, now what we need to focus here? We need to focus on to the puts method, how this particular put method is implemented. So carefully observe, we identify the constructor in the HashMap. We are having four type of constructor. So first is the default, second is expecting capacity. Third one is expecting capacity with the load factor. Fourth one is expecting map as a parameter, right? And hm dot put. thing I want to provide as a John, the value I want to give as a so new double, because the value is having the generic type called double. Cutting the point. So this is the double is provided here. Now, so we'll understand the how this particular put method is going to work. So let me save this particular example. Sorry?
Why did you write new double?
So double is a wrapper class. It is not a primitive data type.
Okay.
So we discussed the difference between primitive type and wrapper classes here. Wrapper classes are objects here. We need to create an object here. So basically, this is also object we are creating, because while discussing this thing, it is a different style to create an object here. So
okay,
because of that, we are not creating an object here. Okay. So back to here, the put method. Now what I'm doing here, I'm moving into this particular. Okay, so it's calling the double constructor here. Now I want to go for the put method. Now you can see the put method. So basically, this particular put method we already discussed when we are trying to call from the hash set here. Internally, hash set is going to use hash map here. Okay, first we'll see so hash code here. How this particular hash is generating based on the key. So this is a hash code of the particular key. Hash code of the particular key, and so this is the key we are passing, and this is the value we are having. So they are making additional two parameters. Okay, now we need to go for the put value method. So we are inside the put value. So now, so what it is doing here? Basically, it's going to create a node array and node and some two into related variables here. So based on this particular condition, now we are moving inside this particular if condition. So what we need to check here, what is the tab? Tab we are getting null, and what is the table we are having? Table also null. So whenever we are getting the table and tab, so the length also we are going to get null, but so we are getting the null point exception because tab is null here. Okay, now we need to see, so based on this particular resize here, we are going to get n value as well as tab. So tab, what is the default to capacity? Now you can see 15. So 0 to 15 is nothing but 16. So we can insert the 16 element inside this particular hash map. And what is the n we are having? So that is called 16. The length we are going to have 16 here. Right. Now, so one more condition we need to understand. So hash we are having, and n minus 1, it will become 15. So we are storing into I. So inside the tab, what is the 15 we are going to have? If it is equals to null, so we are making into this particular field. So this particular condition also, it's satisfying. So now we'll see what is the P. P will become null. Inside this particular 15, like I value we need to check. I value, we are getting 8 here. Okay. Now, so this particular node is creating in a, which index location? This node is going to create in a location called 8 index location. Cutting the point. Now we'll observe based on this. Okay, it's not returning anything. Okay. So what we need to focus here? Where is our tab? Now we can focus in the tab 8th index location. This objects are stored. Cutting the point. So in the 8th index location, this object is stored. Why it is stored in the, like it's stored in the 8th index location here? So because of the particular hash code here. Okay, now, so what we're doing here, we're trying to increasing the count. So after node insertion, we are making null and we are returning back to the this particular put method. So let me click on if right here, I want to add one more object here. Okay, now you can see, so here what I want to keep here something called Tom, and so we need to change the Todd. Finally, we need to work for the some different keys here. Now you can see we are having different keys here. The value I want to provide, so some different value I am trying to give. Right. So these are the values we are trying to store. Right. Now, again, I'm trying to run in the debug mode.
So why the particular,
basically, this particular double is deprecated from the 9 version. So just for providing the information to the compiler, so we added the suppress warning annotation.
Is it mandatory to add or?
So it's not a mandatory, but if I'm not adding here, so we are getting some so lines of code, some yellow colors. So just for removing, we need to add the suppress warning. So the suppress warning is going to remove the deprecation related information. So now you can see if I'm removing this, so here we are getting the lines here. Now you can see the left side sections. The construct of double is deprecated. So just for removing this particular message, I added. Okay, now observe here. Now what I'm doing here, this particular, so John is stored already. Now basically for seeing this particular hash map, we are getting in the zero index location. But internally, so exactly it's storing it. So it is storing in the 8th index location. So now we need to go for the second object here. So now you can see the double is deprecated from the 9 version. Okay, now I want to move. So put value method. I want to make a breakpoint here. Let me make the condition here. So we are inside this particular tab. So the tab is not equals to null and length is not equals to 0. Right. So we need to work for the second condition and hash code for the given key. So this is the hash code for the particular object call Tom. The Tom hash code, what is the hash code we are getting? Something called 84275. Okay, now after this, what we are doing here? So what is the end value we are getting? 16. Again, we are making the 16 minus 1. So 15. And based on this particular 15 and hash code, so we are going to get the particular I, the I value different here. And we are checking the condition. So tab is already we identified. It is a hash map object array. Hash map object array. The first record is stored in the 8th index location. So whatever the value we are going to get. Now you can see here the value we are getting 3. So in the 3 index location, we don't have in the 3 index location, we don't have any record here. Now you can see. So there is no record. Now it will become null here. So whatever the condition they are making, the condition is satisfying here. So if the condition is satisfying, now you can see we are entering into the below code. We are creating new node. And what is the I value we are having? So 3. The newly created node is going to store in the index location called 3. Now you can see. So in the 3 location, the object is stored. And the first record in the 8th index location. cutting the point. So why we are getting the 3? Because of this expression n minus 1 hash code, right? Based on the hash code, we are going to get an index location 3. Okay, so we identified the second record is inserted into the 3 index location. So what about this particular second one? Now you can see what is the key we are getting? Third. So this is a third record we are inserting here. Now focus. So this section of code is giving 8 here. In the 8 index location, already we are having one object here. Getting the point? So in the this particular hash map, in the 8th index location, we are having one record. So whenever we are having one record, because what we are doing here, we are passing here the entire expression, we are passing as a 8th index location, we are checking null. So it is not equal to null because we are having one object. So it is entered into the else block. So we need to focus here. So what we need to understand here, if the two keys are having same hash code, getting the point? If the two keys are having same hash code, so what happens internally? We are moving into the else section. So what we are doing here, p dot hash. What is the p we are having? So jump. Getting the point? So p dot hash, the John related hash code. What is the hash code of this particular John? So the hash code of this particular John, now you can see, so 2314504. Okay, but what is the current hash code we are getting? So 84264. So it is not equal, right? So now you can see, if I'm going to compare here, it is returning false. So both the hash code are not equal here. So what is the two hash code we are comparing? So what is the object which resides in the 8th index location, and what is the current object? So we are checking the hash code. It is not equal, right? And if it is not equals to, we are having one condition and a condition. So this entire expression is not going to satisfy. Okay, and we need to focus on to this. So what is the key? So TD. And here, what is the key? Cutting the point. So what is the key we are going to get? So to understand the key, so we need to understand this particular key. So John. So John and Todd, both are not equals. Both are not equals here. Now you can see entire expression I'm checking here. Okay, so k variable they are inserting, but now you can see the if condition is that, so it's returning false. The if condition, it's returning false here. There, so it is not entered into the line number 636 here. Getting the point? Now it is entered into the else if here. So what is the p we are having? The instance of, we are getting hash map here. So it's not going to satisfying it. So now we need to focus on to the else condition. Now you can see inside the else block, again we are having if condition, else if condition, and else condition. Right. Now inside this particular else condition, so what is the bin count here? Bin count initially we are making 0. Initially we are making 0, and we don't have a conditional block. So we are having iteration block. We are having iteration block. Okay. So anyway, this loop, we enter into the loop. Now we need to focus here. So what is the p dot next? The p dot next we are having null. Cutting the pen. The p dot next, the whatever the node we created earlier, the node, it does not have any references here. Does not have any references here. Getting the point? So if you observe, what I want to provide here for this particular hash map here, how many nodes we created here? So 3 nodes we created. So as of now, we are trying to create 3 nodes here. But if we observe carefully, so this particular three nodes cannot have a relation between these 3. Getting the point? So these 3 nodes cannot have a relation here, because this is located in our 8th index location. So this is located in our third location, but still we are trying to insert it into the 8th location. So we are having one object here. In the 8th index location already, we are having here. Carrying the point. Now, what are the information we are having here for node? Hash and key and value next reference. Same way, now you can see hash, so key, value and next references here. So basically, inside the any node, these are the parameters we are going to have. Inside the any node, we are going to have parameters. But now, what we need to observe, so hash code. So how we are loading the hash code? Now you can see p dot hash. The hash is going to store in the this location. And key will store here. Value will store. And here, next to reference. This is for next to reference. This particular next to reference is when we are going to store. So that is I'm trying to explain here. Now observe p dot next. The p dot next cannot have as of now. So there is no next to references. It will become null. And we are storing into E. So what is the E we are having? So E also null. E also null. And now observe carefully p dot next. P dot next here. So p dot next, what we are doing is we are trying to creating one more node. P dot next, we are creating one more node here. And now we can observe what is a hash. So 84264. So toad key and value, some value. We are making null. What is a null here? What is a null here? It is a next reference. Carrying the point, it is a next reference. Now observe. So p dot next we are having. P dot next we are having. Now if you want to see p dot next, we are having the toad related information. Getting the point. Now what you understand this particular diagram here? So now it is having the references like this. The particular next node is having to the this particular. So the hash we are having 264. The key we are having something called toad. Some value we are having here, right? So now currently, so it will become null. Getting the point? Currently, it will become null. Now, what you are understanding is, so whenever we are having the based on the hash code, if I am going to get the same index location, first it will check whether hash code is same or key is same. Getting the point? Hash code and the key same. What happens internally? Only the value is going to change. But some cases, what happening here? If the hash code and the key not matching here, so for this particular node is going to making the one more node reference like this here, right? So as of now, this node is not pointing to the any references here, right? So back to here. Now what we are doing here? We are trying to find out the, so the condition is not satisfying. So E is not equals to null. No, it is a null. So we are making the mod count here. Getting the point. So this is very important. We need to understand here. Whenever the how the hash map internally is working. How the hash map is internally it is working here. Okay, now we can see. So tab is not a null. We need to check for the second. And we need to understand the. So what is the index location we are getting? 11. So in the 11 index location, happily we are going to insert it here. Right. So now I am trying to find out in here. So this is a n minus 1 8 here. Now observe one more 8 we came. So this is also important. One more 8 we came. So now what we can do? So here it is checking. So p dot hash and current hash. So true. So p dot hash and p dot key also we need to check here. So basically, okay, from here we need to check. Okay, k cannot be resolved here. Okay, basically, so hash is satisfied. Now we need to see. So what is the p dot key we are getting here? P dot key John we are getting. What is the key we are getting? John. Okay. Now this condition is satisfying here. If this particular condition is satisfying, now what we are doing here? So E equals to P. Now observe carefully. So E equals to P. Whatever the P object we are having, so what is the P object? The John object we are getting. So now we are insert, storing into this particular E. E is not equals to null. E not equals to null. Now what you are understanding? E dot value. So whatever the value we are having, the old value we are getting here. So old value. If absent, what is absent here? It's false. It will become true. So now we can see what we are doing here. So this is the old value, E dot value. Now we can see E dot value is right side. So the purpose of when we are making the right side, we are loading the value. When we are making left side, we are initializing the value. So see the difference. Here E dot value we used here, and here also we are using the E dot value. But here we are loading the old value. Here we are initializing the new value. 9654. And what is the old value? 3232. 3232. Right? So we are old value. So if we overridden with the old value, now it will become 9654. Now we are coming back out of the condition. Right? So this is all about the hash map internal work. So this is very important here. Basically, the default capacity we are having 16 here. So based on this particular key, we are going to find out the appropriate index location. And if the two keys are having same index location, now what we are doing here? So we are going to check for the hash code and key. If the both are not matching here, now we'll try to create a next node here. Next node here. So for example here, now what we are going to do? So one more object we receive. So for this particular next node, we are making null. And here we are going to create a one more node. Sorry, we will create a, so these are the references for the next node. Again, we are going to make null here. Getting the one. So this is the way the nodes internally is having their relations here. The nodes internally having the relations here. Getting the point. Now we created this particular put method. Now we need to focus on to the get method. Getting the point. So hm dot get method. So here we need to provide the get object here. So this particular object I want to give one by one. So I don't want to give so explicitly. The key we need to, so coming, we need to get from the this particular section of code. So where we define the hash map here. I want to load key sets here. So hm dot key sets here. So what is doing here? This particular key sets here. Okay, so first we print this particular key sets. So otherwise, first we'll see how this particular key set is implemented. Now let me run here. I want to remove. Finally, I want to put a breakpoint on the key set here. I am moving inside this particular key set. So key set, this is the key set. Key set is null. Right. If the key set is null, what they are doing here? So they are creating new key set here. And whenever they are creating new key set here, now observe. These many key set we are making here. So how this the key set is created? How this particular key set is created? Key set is a one more class which is created inside this particular hash map. Right. Now observe the constructor. How the constructor is worked internally. Where is the constructor we are having? Iterator returns hash map dot clear. Okay. Okay. So there is no the default constructor here. Size clear iterator remove and remove node we are having. Hash map for iterator contents. Okay, so it's actually we have implemented for each. Okay, so basically, okay, so we don't have a those information. How whenever we are calling this particular default key set here, because they did not provide the default key set information. But now we can see whenever we are calling this particular key set, we are getting. So these are the keys here. Okay, so this is all about the key set information we identified. Now what I'm trying to write here. So this particular key set, I want to go for the loop here. So string key, and here observe based on this particular key, I want to load an object here. I want to load an object here. HM dot get object here. The key I'm trying to pass key. So the key also I'm trying to give dynamically. So instead of making static here, now what we can do? So key set, we are going to get multiple key set, set of string. Set of string as number, we'll get an a multiple keys here. So whenever I'm trying to get multiple keys here, I'm trying to repeat one by one with the help of this particular loop call for each year. Okay, now, so click on this particular for each year. Now we are enter into the this particular get key. Now I'm trying to work on the key. What is the key we are getting right now? Okay, so anyway, we'll go for the get method. Now observe get method. What is the key we are getting? Tom. The key we are getting Tom here. Now, first, if you observe carefully, what we are doing is we are generating hash code. This is the hash code of this particular Tom. And again, what we are doing here? So we are calling get node here. So how this particular node we are trying to find it? Where exactly the node is going to find? Okay, let me go for the internal this particular hash code. Now I'm moving get node here. So carefully observe get node method. We need to focus on to the get node method. So how this particular get node is going to work? Okay, so these are the variables declared here. So what this particular tab is having node array. This is the first node. And they are having E also. So some int and K. Okay. So this is the hash code and this is the key. Okay. What is the table we are having? In the table, we are having some records here. Table, we are having some records. In the 8th index location, so we are having John, comma, double. But here we don't have a scope to find the next information. Okay. Anyway, table is not equal to null. We are assigning into tab and tab dot length. So this particular tab dot length also we are going to get around 16, and we are storing into this particular n, and those are greater than or equals to null. But here we need to focus this particular hash. So here we need to focus the line number 570 tab. So tab we already identified, because from the table we are copying into this particular tab here. Okay, now focus what we are getting here. Okay, n also we cannot identify. Okay, finally we'll see. So basically now we have a scope to find out the hash here. What is the index we are getting? The index we are getting 3. Getting the point. The Tom is stored in the index 3 or not. So correct. We are getting Tom object here. And it is not equal to null. So here we need to check the hash. What is the hash we are having here? So 84275. And I'm trying to checking both hash code is same or not. So both hash code is same. Along with we are checking key also. Both the keys are same or not. So both the keys also same here. So whenever both the keys are same, now we can see we are returning first. We are returning first. The object we are returning. Right, sometimes hash code and key is not matched for the 8th index location. We'll see the term is printing here, right? Now I'm moving, so one more key. So the key here, we are not getting it. The key here, John. So this is important, John. Okay, now go for the hash code and get node. So tab, so it's satisfying. What is the first we are getting? So John we are getting. Here we are going to get 8 here. Right, now we need to check for the hash code, both are same or not. Both are same. So thus John we are returning. Okay, so this is identified. So what about this particular, so this record, maybe what is the key we are having? Todd. Yes, so this particular Todd also, so it's going to provide same index location, same index location. Now observe 8. So this we need to understand. Now you can see this hash code is not going to satisfy. This hash code is not going to satisfy, and the key also not going to satisfy. Let's see, we need to check for the one more. Now what you are understanding is first dot next, right? The first dot next here, we are having one reference or not? Getting the point? This node is pointing to the next is pointing to the one more node. Now it will become not equals to null. It will become not equals to null. Now we are storing into this particular E. Now you can see, so the first is not a tree node. Now we are moving into this particular do while loop. So we are moving into do while loop. So it will satisfy. Now we are returning this. So if it is not satisfying also, what it will do? It will check for the next here. Now you can see e dot next, right? The e dot next. So sometimes what happens here, if I'm going to make another node, we'll make so for this node, right? So this is the way, so it's going to look for the this section of code. So this section of code here, getting the point? So this is very important. We need to understand whenever we are having the node is having one more node. So this is the way the objects are going to return here. The objects are going to load here, getting the point? So this is, we need to focus on to the key set we identified, get key method also we identified here internally. So how it is checking here, and we need to focus on to the put remove method. We need to focus on to the remove method. So to remove also, here I'm going to provide, I want to remove all the objects here. How the all the objects are going to remove here? Click on F8 here. So key set, click on remove method. Now you can see for the remove node also. So careful observe, for the remove node also, now what we are doing here? Again, we are trying to find out the hash code. Again, we are trying to find out the hash code here. So hash code we are generating, and now we are moving inside this particular remove node. Now observe. So remove node, this particular table we are storing into tab, and length we are storing. And here, now you can see, based on this particular hash, we are trying to load the index as well as we are trying to load the particular T object here. Now we'll see. So they declare the variables here, and P dot hash. What is the hash code we are getting? So 87275. Whether these two are matching or not? So these are matching. So if it is matching, now what they are doing here? Node equals to P. The node we are making P. Right, so this is the node we will understand here. So this particular node we are going to remove here. The term we are going to remove, node not equals to null, and so the match value, some value we are having the condition. here we are checking value is equals to value or value equals to V. So just we are checking. So anyway, the condition will satisfy. Right, it is not a tree node. So here we are checking node equals to equals to P. It is true. It is true. Now what we are doing is, so any node dot in node dot next year. If it is this particular node is having next year, no. So this particular next year we don't have here. So what is the index we are having? 3. Now what you are understanding is node dot next year. Basically, if this per current node is having any references here, so for example, this node is having, this node is having into the this object here, carrying the parent. Now, so this node will available in the index location. So this particular node will available in the third index location. But current example, for this particular current example, we don't have a next node. We are making null. So the reference we are making null here inside the tab. So in that third index location we are having null. Okay. So that from the hash map the node is removed here. From the hash map the node is removed here. So whatever the node we removed here, now we are trying to returning here the particular node. So this is the term we are trying to returning. Now we can see. So if it is a e dot value we are getting. The e dot value we are trying to print here. So this is all about the remove node value. Okay, so in the loop we are trying to removing here. So because of this we are getting an error here. But now we understand here how this particular remove method is working. Cutting the point. So this is very important to we need to understand here. The remove method, so clear method and key set we identified, so we need to go for the values here. So we need to understand the values here. So to understand the values, now what I want to write here, instead of remove we can go for the hm dot values, hm dot values here, how this particular values is working. How this particular values is working. Now observe here the get method is calling into the I came out of the values here. What I will do, I will put a breakpoint here. Okay, now we are inside, like we are trying to move inside this particular values method. So as of now, so values is null. As of now, values is null. Now we can see, so values is a one more class. Values is also one more class here. So we'll make a breakpoint here. Maybe, so where it is calling here because of this, let's see where they implemented here. We'll go for the, maybe this is also calling values dot values. Okay. Close. Okay. So here, then they are creating values there. Okay.
Okay. So I will check here how this particular values are coming. But observe, when we are calling this particular values here, we are going to get this particular VS, so which is returning from the this particular values here. Okay, now if we want to return this particular values, so this is a way we can make the collection. From the collection, we need to loop one more time. For which I want to take double values, right? Yes. Double one. So this section of code is going to provide values. Now you can see the last one. These are the values coming from the this values. If I'm going to copy, like comment this section of code. Getting the point. So these are the values coming from the this particular values here. So this is all about the method which are available inside this particular so hash map. Now, so same method we'll try to check with tree map. So tree map is also one of the implementation class for the navigable map as well as sorted map. So this tree map tomorrow we are going to discuss here. So how exactly the tree map is going to work. So once the tree map is completed, we'll check for the comparator, and once the comparator is completed, we are close to complete the our collection frameworks here. Okay, we'll try to continue tomorrow for the remaining concepts called tree map here. So any questions regarding our today's session?
Not today, but I want to know, have you taken a class on, I mean, have you showed how to set up the Eclipse to see these interfaces and classes which you show predefined?
Yes, I provided. So basically, you need to click on the open type, Control Shift T. So here you can type the whatever the interfaces class you want to see here.
Okay. And if in a project, if in the company we are working with IntelliJ IDE, then can we also install Eclipse and work on Eclipse as well?
Yes, you can. No problem. So the code also import into the Eclipse.
Sorry, what did you say?
The code we can import into the Eclipse also. So whatever the code you are working in the IntelliJ IDE, so we can work with Eclipse also.
Okay, but when I'm trying to work with Eclipse, it is giving me many errors. So I thought maybe because I have IntelliJ, that's why it is giving. So
no, so maybe you did not import it properly, but we can work whatever the code we are working on the different IDs. So there is no restrictions here.
Okay, have you provided in any of your lecture how to set up this Eclipse?
So, like, what do you want to set up here?
No, because I'm getting error when I'm trying to run the code in Eclipse. For normal Spring Boot project also, it gives error, which it doesn't give in IntelliJ, same code.
So that we need to check here, like, what is the error you are getting here?
Okay.
So just, can you show me, like, what is the exception you are, screenshot? So I will let you know, like, what is the error you are getting.
Okay. Can I provide you tomorrow? Because at present, I did not open the laptop through mobile. I was watching.
Okay. No problem.
Yeah. Otherwise, I will send you on your number with a screenshot everything.
Yes. Yes. You can send me the screenshot. We'll see, like, what error you are getting.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. Thank you.
Okay.